Hello students, in the last video lecture we have gone through problems on multi-tray settling chamber in which we understand how to find out a mean particle diameter by using Stokes' law. Now in this lecture we will understand how to find out efficiency of equipment by considering a fiber filter. So we will consider one problem for fiber filter in this lecture. We will go through the problem statement. A hot gas from a foundry operations are sent to a fiber filter made up of glass wool fiber. Okay, so fiber bags are there in a fiber filter, and these are in this problem, these are made up of glass wool. The diameter of that fiber bags are 10 micron in a diameter. The thickness of fiber mat is 2 mm. The gas containing particles of average size 1 micron flow through a fiber mat. The velocity of gas which is coming into the fiber bed is 0.6 meter per second. Find out the grade efficiency of fiber filter if the void fractions of your bed is equal to 0.96 is given. Okay, so data for this problem is given as density of your gas is 0.0011 gram per centimeter cube. Viscosity of gas is 0.02 centipoise. Diffusivity of 1 micron particle is 2.7 into 10 to minus 7 centimeter square per second. Okay, so this is what the problem statement is, and we have to find out the grade efficiency of your fiber filter. Okay, and for this the data is given. Now we'll try to understand what is given in the problem. Diameter of your fiber is given as bag is given as 10 micron, and that is denoted by capital D, and that is equal to 10 into 10 raised to minus 4 centimeter. Gas containing particles of size particles that are present into the gas are denoted, the size of that particles are denoted by dp, and that is equal to 1 micron. Gas velocity is equal to u is equal to 0.6 meter per second, and that is equal to 60 centimeter per second, because all the units are all the data that has been given in the problem statement is a CGS unit. That's why whatever the data present into SI system, that we have to convert into CGS system. That's why it is we convert the unit of your velocity to centimeter per second. Density of air or density of gas, we can say it is given as 0.0011 gram per centimeter cube. Viscosity of gas is given as 0.02 centipoise, that is equal to 0.02 into 10 raised to minus 2 gram per centimeter second. Okay, again the thickness of your fiber bed or fiber material is given, or bag is given, that is denoted by HT, and that is equal to 2 mm, and that will be equal to 0.2 centimeter. Okay, we can see here that is the thickness of your fiber bag is given as 2 mm. Okay, so it is denoted by HT. To find out the grade efficiency, first we need to find out the target efficiency, and it is denoted by nu T, which is given by empirical equation. Nu T is equal to 6 into Schmidt number raised to minus 2 by 3 into Reynolds number raised to minus 1 by 2 plus 3 into R square into Reynolds number raised to 1 by 2. Okay, so Schmidt number is equal to, we need to find out all this Schmidt number, Reynolds number, and this R. R is nothing but your dimensionless parameter, and which is ratio of diameter of particle to the diameter of your fiber bag. Okay, so first of all we will try to find out the Schmidt number. Schmidt number is equal to mu divided by d into dm into rho. Dm is your diffusivity of 1 mm diameter particle, which has been given in the problem statement. Rho is the density, mu is the viscosity of your gas. Okay, so viscosity is given as 0.02 centipoise. We will convert it into poise into 10 raised to minus 2, just multiplied by 10 raised to minus 2. Dm, that is diffusivity of 1 mm diameter particle, it is given in the problem statement. Diffusivity is given as 2.7 into 10 raised to minus 7 centimeter square per second. Okay, so we'll put all this value 0.02 into 10 raised to minus 2, diffusivity 2.7 into 10 raised to minus 7 into 0.01, that is density is given as 0.0011. Schmidt number is equal to 6.734 into 10 raised to 5, it is coming out. Okay, so Reynolds number is equal to du rho upon mu. So diameter of your fiber bed is given as 10 micron, and that will convert into centimeter, 10 into 10 raised to minus 4 centimeter, multiplied by velocity of your gas coming into the fiber filter. It is 0.6 meter per second. Okay, we will convert it into centimeter per second, that is 60 centimeter per second. Okay, density is given as 0.0011 divided by viscosity is 0.02 into 10 raised to minus 2. in all units, in all the dimensions, we have to consider for the unit consistency. Okay, we have kept all the units in a CGS system. So Reynolds number is coming out as 0.33. Schmidt number and Reynolds numbers are dimensionless numbers. That's why no unit. Okay, so value of R, it is ratio of diameter of particle to the diameter of your fiber bag. So diameter of your particle is 1 micron. Average diameter of particle is given as 1 micron. And diameter of your fiber bag is coming out as 10 micron. So it is coming out as 0.1 micron overall. Okay, next we will put all these values into the this empirical equation of target efficiency. Okay, so it is coming out as 6 into what is there, it is Schmidt number. Schmidt number is coming out as 6.734 into 10 raised to 5 raised to 2 by 3 minus 2 by 3 into Reynolds number, that is 0.33 raised to minus 1 by 2 plus 3 into R. R is coming out as 0.1, that is diameter of your particle to the diameter of your fiber bag, 0.1 square into Reynolds number, that is 0.33 raised to 1 by 2. So target efficiency is equal to 0.01859. Okay, now this is target efficiency. When there is a white fraction is given, we have to correct the target efficiency. So as to use to find out the grade efficiency. Okay, so grade efficiency is required. For grade efficiency, it is required to find out the target efficiency. But if the void fractions are given, here the void fractions of your bag is given, so we have to correct the target efficiency. And to correct the target efficiency, there is formula. Correct target efficiency is equal to target efficiency that we have find out without considering the void fraction, multiplied by 1 plus 4.5 into 1 minus your void fractions. Okay, so target efficiency is equal to 0.01859 into 1 plus 4.5 into 1 minus 0.96. This is your void fractions. So target efficiency is equal to 0.02194. Okay, so this is the corrected target efficiency by considering the void fractions. And that target efficiency we will use to find out the grade efficiency. So grade efficiency is denoted by capital E, and that is equal to 1 minus exponential of minus 4 into 1 minus void fractions into HT, that is thickness of your fiber bag, into target efficiency corrected divided by pi into diameter of your fiber bag multiplied by void fractions. Okay, so 1 minus exponential of minus 4 into 1 minus void fraction is 0.96 multiplied by thickness of your bed is 0. It is given as 2 mm, so it will be equal to 0.2 centimeter multiplied by target efficiency is 0.02194 divided by pi into diameter of your fiber bag is given as 10 micron, that is equal to 10 into 10 raised to minus 4 centimeter multiplied by your void fraction is 0.96. It is equal to, answer of this is coming out as 0.0975, 1 minus 0.0975, that will be equal to 0.9025. So that will be equal to 90.25%. So efficiency of your or grade efficiency of your fiber filter is coming out as 90.25%. Likewise, we can find out efficiency or grade efficiency or efficiency with which the fiber filter is operating by using the given data. And we can in a similar way we can find out for fiber filter of other specification at what efficiency this fiber filter is operating. Okay, thank you very much. In next video lecture, we will go through the problems on gravity settling chamber. Okay, in that we will try to find out the efficiency and grade efficiency for the gravity settling chamber. Thank you very much.